Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to be talking about one of the most important tools that every beginner Android developer should know, and that is Logcat. Logcat is a powerful debugging tool that allows you to view the logs generated by your application. In simple words, it helps you to find and identify the errors. So basically, when you run the application in your emulator or in your physical device, Logcat will start recording every single detail about your application and generate those details in a log format. Sometimes you might have came across a situation where your app crashes suddenly and you have no idea why did that happen. But don't worry, because Logcat has captured that crash. You can open the Logcat and check the errors. Then further you can investigate more on them. To understand it better, let's move to our Android Studio. This is one of my previous projects in which I am going to deliberately create errors to show you how exactly Logcat works. Just to give you an overview, we have a button. We kept the ID as my button, okay? Now move to main activity. We have declared a variable my button and we have initialized it as well. Then when we click on that button, it will show a toast as you have clicked a button. Simple, right? But now let's deliberately make an error by not initializing my button. So I'll comment this line. So when you comment any line, it does not count at the time of compilation. Okay. Now let's see if our Logcat is able to capture that error or not. So there are two ways to access Logcat. The very first way is to click on View, then Tools window, then Logcat. And the second way is quite simple. Navigate to the bottom of the screen and click on Logcat tab. Logcat will work only when your emulator or physical device is connected. As you can see, my emulator is not connected, hence it is showing us offline. So let's first run the emulator. Logcat will show all the logs generated by the device or emulator. However, package might make sure that the logs are filtered to only show the logs generated by our application. We can also use the filtering options to filter the logs based on errors, warnings, information. Press Ctrl plus space, it will show you filter suggestions. Click on level, then choose error. All unnecessary logs are filtered. Now Logcat will only show errors. You can stack trace them to figure out where exactly that error came from. So when I click on main activity, it shows this specific line. This is where the error was triggered. Now let's read the detailed sentence error to understand it better. So there are two errors and both of them refer to one thing, that is null object reference. So the error says that we are invoking on a clicklistener method on a null object, and that null object is nothing but our my button itself. But why is it referring as null? Because we have not initialized it. I know this, but as a beginner you might not aware about it. So the best place to find a solution for this is Stack Overflow. So all you have to do is copy the entire sentence and paste it in the browser and refer the very first link of Stack Overflow. You will find the solution in a generalized way. So for example, this particular error happens for a different reason, and you will find every reason over here. Use your mind and find a correct solution for your problem. For this error, let me remove the comment and initialize my button. Now let's run the emulator again and see. No errors were captured in the Logcat. Great. Now let's click on the button and a toast appears as you have clicked the button. Perfect. Now it works absolutely fine. So yeah, at the end, I just want to say that if you really want to become a good Android developer, you have to keep doing trial and error with your code. And that's how you will able to understand your code better. Also, you can join our Telegram group where we can discuss errors and solutions regarding Android, link in the description box. So yeah, that is it for the video. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.